What's going on, guys? Today I want to share with you the top three sexiest muscle groups that's going to have the biggest difference on the way that you look. Now, of course, your height, your facial aesthetics, your style, your overall body symmetry and proportions is going to be the biggest thing here. But these three areas, when you work on them, is going to make the biggest impact on your physique, hands down. So let's break these down. Number one, the most attractive muscle group that you can develop, hands down, would have to be the neck. Now, I know some of you guys are thinking, what? The neck? Of all things, you're talking about the neck? Yes. Because what you have to understand is that facial aesthetics is everything. You can have a good-looking body, but if your face does not look on point, you're ruining a lot of the packages, right? And that's why you'll see a lot of times guys who look good in the face, mediocre bodies, but you're getting with all kinds of men or women because face is very important. Now, the thing is this, right? Having a wider neck will make you look more attractive in the face because it accentuates your jaw. It makes your jaw look bigger. It's a magical effect. You have to, listen, I would encourage all you guys to go on Photoshop and widen your neck a little bit. Okay, in fact, how about we look at the most attractive men that exist on the planet, at least by society's expectations, right? Go on Google Images and type in good-looking men. What you will find is that 9 out of 10 times, if not 100% of the time, they have wider necks. You'll see them with like average-looking bodies, but they got the wide neck. The neck is closer to the ears. The neck is closer to the side of the cheeks. It's not super, super narrow. I'm telling you, folks, if you get a wider neck, it will have the biggest impact in the way that your face looks. It's going to change you completely because it makes you look more rectangular, less puffy, less fat in the face. And that's another benefit right there. Neck training, right, will make sure that the fat you have on your face distributes through a larger surface area, which actually makes you look leaner automatically. And if you combine that with like a little bit of a stubble or some shit to add a little bit more definition to the face, now you're looking really, really good. So the neck, hands down, most important muscle group for enhancing your sex appeal. Do it yourself. Photoshop your neck. It makes a big difference. All the best actors have wide necks. All the most attractive men have wider necks. I'm telling you this as a fact. So build that neck up with some neck extensions, neck curls, neck side raises, bridging. Check out my yoga playlist. I teach you how to do that. The second most important muscle group for looking sexy is the upper back. Because as men, we have the great advantage of having the nice V-taper, that masculine V-taper. That is what's going to make or break you. Because here's the thing. If you have like these narrow little shoulders and these wide little hips, guess what? You look like a woman. Or not like a woman. Obviously, you can't look like a woman. You don't have those proportions, but it doesn't look as manly, right? And there's something biological when you see a guy with wide fucking shoulders, like a wide upper back. Another thing, right? When you have that nice upper back, your clothes change, right? The way your clothes fall on your body changes completely. It'll raise the sleeves a little bit higher, which accentuates your arms. Never thought about that, but it's true. And it's going to make you look broad. And broadness is just very good looking, man. Especially like when you're walking down the street, it changes your walk. Notice how lifters, the elite naturals, have a different walk. It's a masculine walk. You can walk with the lats. I'm not talking about imaginary lat syndrome. That shit is not sexy. When you have a guy with narrow ass shoulders, narrow back, and he's flaring like this, thinking he's Mr. Buff. No, in that case, you just look stupid. But if you genuinely have a thick upper back, you know, and it tapers down to like a more narrow waist. I'm not saying you gotta have a tiny waist here, but if you have the V taper, right? Well, guess what? That shit looks fucking amazing. So the upper back, especially when you turn around, when you're walking, you're gonna have that nice masculine walk, right? When people look at you from the back, you're gonna see from the front, you're gonna have a different walk. It changes the way your clothes fit you. Actually, the upper back has the greatest impact on your shirt size. Are you aware of that? When you measure your upper back, you're measuring the entire circumference of the upper body. You're measuring your shoulders in there, right? You're measuring your chest. So essentially, upper back, if you can increase the size of that area, it's gonna have the biggest impact on your shirt size. And that right there is a very big benefit, especially if you're wearing tighter clothes and it's tight up here. Trust me, it's gonna make you look way, way better. And then the last muscle that really enhances your sex appeal is the glutes. Hell yes, the glutes are everything, guys. You have no idea. Everybody thinks that it's chest and arms, right? No, it's glutes. In fact, multiple studies have actually shown that women love glutes on a man. And I know from personal experience that women love glutes. I've had women grab my ass. I've had women come up to me and say, "You got a nice ass." In fact, in high school, some chicks, I used to hear them in the background, they would say, "Oh, that's the guy with the nice ass." I'm telling you, anybody who does a lot of squats, a lot of deadlifts, anybody who has a well-developed posterior chain, you know what I'm talking about. You know exactly what I'm talking about. These women assault you. And dudes like it too. Bring up those glutes. I'm telling you, it's gonna have a major impact. First of all, When you're sideways, you're going to have the nice pop, right? From the side with the upper back. So it complements it very well. And when you turn around, you just look very masculine, man. Like you have the thick upper back. You got the mountainous glutes popping out. Trust me, this is the ultimate look. What you're looking for, guys, is a wide neck, thick and wide upper back, and then the glutes that pop out. This is the most important thing. These are the top three areas, hands down. When you get pants, the glutes is going to make you look different when you wear it, right? You're going to have the pop coming out. Trust me, it changes the game forever, okay? And I'm telling you, men and women love glutes. And that, my friends, are the top three areas for looking sexier. Of course, there are other areas that can do the same thing. I would say the arms, believe it or not, can enhance that. If you have a nice pair of guns and it's hugging the sleeves, definitely it's going to make you look better. And we can even argue the six-pack. I wouldn't say shredded abs, but I would say if you're like 15% body fat and you have some definition in your midsection, I would say that could be very sexy too, especially when people like rub their fingers down your abs. So definitely these are the areas that you need to focus on the most if you're trying to maximize your attractiveness. Neck, this is non-debatable. You need to get a bigger neck. Upper back, very, very important for the broadness effect. Broadness is key. And the glutes for giving you that pop, you know? And we can also argue about like thrusting power, right? If we look at biology, maybe that's a reason why glutes are very attractive. If you have that like that big ass, trust me, like a lot of dudes are scared of developing their ass. They want to get quads, but trust me, quads is not what makes your legs look sexy. It's the glutes, 100%, especially when they're tight in your pants, makes all the difference. So those are my top three areas. Now, I want to know from you guys, what do you believe are the top three areas? I'm just sharing with you my opinion, what I believe to be 100% true. I gave you my reasoning for it. But now I want to know, what areas do you think? Top 3 to 5, which is going to enhance you the most? I want to know. And with that, I will talk to you all next time.